It's good, YouTube. I'm trying to get all this shit done. You know what kind of guy I am. I'm gonna talk about a little thing that people keep saying which isn't true. And that's that the left and the right don't matter. The left and right dichotomy is worthless because it's devoid of any philosophy. That's true. There's no such thing as leftism or rightism. They're devoid of any philosophy. They're just a contrasting spectrum. But what does that really mean? Well, what that means is that if you're part of the left, you could have the same exact philosophy and still be opposed to the right. People think, well, at this point, they make an oversimplification that this is bullshit. There's no philosophy, therefore, these beliefs are worthless or devoid. To that, I say all philosophies are beliefs, but not all beliefs are philosophies. I have a good analogy to this. I was listening to one of these bands that I used to like, and their new album sounds nothing like their previous work, and I don't really like it. Yet, people identify themselves as a fan and said, "How dare you dislike this? You're not a true fan." And really, at this case, I wasn't liking the previous sound as a means of being the fan. I was being a fan as a means of liking the sound. I always put philosophy before identity, but it doesn't really matter because the way I see it, most people don't look at things in a philosophical manner. They don't really have much of a point in doing so. Schools don't teach philosophy for a reason. They teach you to identify yourself with something. And you can think about it, and by the way, they tell you to live life. They tell you, you gotta have a dream, you gotta have a reason to live, otherwise you'll be a piece of shit who isn't worth living. I'm not kidding, they might actually use that language at you. They want you to have an identity. Kids have identity issues. They don't have philosophy issues. They don't struggle with searching for a philosophy. In this case, I agree. Most of the time, regular people don't really need a philosophy. I think libertarianism needs to realize this. People identify themselves with something. They don't care about the philosophy. If libertarianism sounds glam or it sounds like something they'll like, then they'll identify themselves with this. And they could drop the philosophy. Personally, I support libertarianism because of a small fragment of its philosophy, the Rothbardian philosophy. I despise the Smithian, Adam Smith, the Lockean, and the Randian beliefs. I only like one. Everything else can pretty much go to hell. If I don't hear something that doesn't sound correct to me, then I'll drop it. If libertarianism turns into a complete piece of shit, then I'll drop that belief. I'm not gonna keep going with a belief because it turns into bullshit. That's why I don't like this minarchist-esque libertarianism where people advocate states to weaken government regulation. I think it's backwards. It fails to understand what empowers the state. Wait, when powers the destruction of government? It's not government, it's the state. pretty much all I have to say. I'm very unenthusiastic right now. But as you know, I've had a very, very shitty day. And I'm glad that it's almost over. As a matter of fact, it's been over a long time ago. Well, I'm Mr. Wonka 7 and... or Leon Red. Whatever the hell they call me. And this is a wrap. In conclusion, the way you identify yourself is important. I don't find it important, but more normal people do find this important. You gotta find a way to keep both of these lines in a good position. Got a piece, you know, without philosophy, the soft core group, and the hardcore philosophers. See, soft core, hardcore. Anyway, this is Mr. Rock 7. Suck my dick.